There was an article that came in Time magazine, and we know that Time magazine is one of the most popular weekly magazine in the world. An article came on the 15th of July 1974, and on the cover page it mentioned, who are the history's great leaders? So what Time magazine did, they requested the historians, the writers, the businessmen to comment who do they think are the best leaders in the world, in the history.
Time 誌、これは我々が知っているように世界で最も有名な週刊誌の一つですけれども、この中で特集が組まれました。歴史上、人類史上最も最高のリーダーは誰かという特集が組まれました。
From those who gave the opinion, many, they mentioned the name of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. They could not resist, but mentioned the fact. One such person, his name is William McNeill.
このタイム誌に意見を寄せた人たちの多くの人がムハンマド預言者様の名前を挙げました。そのうちの一人がウィリアム・マグニーになります。
William McNeill is an historian from the University of Chicago, USA. And he says that if leadership has to be judged by the impact, I would say the world's greatest leaders were Jesus, Buddha, Muhammad, maybe Lenin, possibly Mao. But if you have to implement anyone today, in today's age, I would say John F. Kennedy. William McNeill did not give the reasons for his choice, but he had the guts to mention the name of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, amongst one of the greatest leaders in the ministry. Here, James Gavin goes out of his way and places Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, as number one amongst the world's greatest leaders in history. William McNeill had said that if results are to judge, then the world's greatest leaders are Jesus, Buddha, Muhammad, and Confucius, the prophets of the religion. Another person by the name of Jules Massaman, who was a psychoanalyst in the University of Chicago, before he gives the answer, he puts down his criteria that a leader should cater to three things. A leader should fulfill three conditions. Number one, provide the well-being of the led. Number two, provide a social organization where the people feel relatively secure. And third is that he gives one set of beliefs to the people, provides one set of beliefs to the people. If these three are the criteria for judgment of a great leader, he said that Gandhi and Confucius may be leaders in the first sense. And he said that Lenin and Sark would be leaders in the first sense. Gandhi and Confucius on one hand, and Alexander and Caesar and Hitler on the other hand, would be leaders in the second sense and maybe in the third sense. Jesus and Buddha would be leaders only in the third sense. But the greatest leader in human history would be Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who fulfilled all the three senses. And Moses somewhat did the same to a lesser extent. Imagine a Jew in America is saying the greatest leader after giving criteria in the history was Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. But the most shocking amongst all is he gives number one to the last and final messenger of Islam, to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. People would worry, people would wonder, why has this American in America, why has he given a Muslim as number one, the most influential persons in history, right from Adam till today? Why? We would wonder why. And he places Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, number three, and Moses, peace be upon him, as number 15.